up, everybody? How's it doing?
Competition without a superstar or two, and this guy right here certainly fits that billing. Yeah, no surprise here. Anytime you can get your hands on a player of his caliber, I think you pretty well have to pull the trigger. Yeah, maybe not the pick that's gonna change this team's fortune, but he is an improvement over what they had. She wants to overthrow our life. We've seen one Jet player be taken already. Could a second be right behind? Still some big holes remaining to be filled. And this team does have a lot of needs, but this guy is a legitimate star, and he'll make everyone around him better. Well, not too tough to see into the thought process of that. To now, do you get yourself a big brute for the trenches or someone who can really help you out at a playmaker type spot? Now it's getting to the time of the draft where you really want to get lucky and hope somebody falls into your lap. All up in my face, you're not from the clique. These are tough decisions here, offense or defense. Which side has the more pressing need? This a mud, yeah, this a mud. Friends and business don't mix, so I'm brotherless. Trying to get back close, hit them with the stiff. Gears I shift, make sure they feel it. Yeah, that's the kind of guy who can elevate that entire unit. He's a very talented addition. Yeah, and next song I said, I'm just proud of my accomplishments. I'm a 400, I don't care at all. And now, which side of the football will they address here? Some interesting options either way. Could we see another Buffalo Bill come off the board here? Yeah, here's a spot where the fan base would be clamoring for a skill player. But do you listen to him or go after? And I think that pick comes to the surprise of nobody. You had to figure they leaned that way if a player from that team became available. But I got it all handled. They try to box me and I got my own angles, yeah. I'ma spend the summer getting to the cake and I'ma wishing put on every candle. I'm like, please, please tell me why you always leave. Why you wait? Please tell me why you always leave. Please, please tell me why you always leave. Why you wait? Please tell me why you always leave. Please, please tell me why you always leave. Why you wait? Please tell me why you always leave. Please, please tell me why you always leave. But you know now, Juicy can't throw with the verse for me both times. In Pot Town, that's automatic, hold down. What's that? Ask no questions, just hold it down. Why you hating?
All right, Larry, thank you. It is indeed time for a draft champions matchup and what is set to be a great draft champions matchup. In the booth, I'm Brandon Gaudin with Charles Davis, and these guys should have a huge impact on the outcome of this game. They're ready to roll. We're ready to roll. Let's roll. And it's the birth of a new club as we're underway in draft champions. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And last year, that would have been a net gain of 5 on the return. This year, he stopped where he would have been if he had taken a knee. And that's at the 25. They'll come out in the pistol. Again, we'll see the pistol here. Now the first carry here for Todd Gurley. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
A 1 yard gain could look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of 1 yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional 1 yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that. Come back and get them the next time.
The defense won that so fast that I think if the running back even had time to notice if an angle was there, it was just a blink of an eye, and there was a loss on the play.
3 and out, a real danger here on their opening drive as they come up on a 3rd and 12. Now a give running left for Gurley. And he'll be rolling to 30 here. It's a pickup of 6, but it's not going to be enough. And the punt team's going to be summoned on 4th down.
Leverage wins. Offensive line lower than the defensive front. They moved them and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
Here we go. It's Gurley. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Cardinals will now take over with excellent field position. So they take a big, big chance here in their own territory. And you think the coach may have some questions to answer?
Yeah, and, you know, normally we focus on the media, right? The social media barrage that he's going to get for this one. How about on his own sideline and in his locker room? Because I think the team's going to look at him like, coach, why would we go for it there? I mean, no confidence in the defense. You don't like the punter. I mean, what's going on here? You owe us some explanations.
Right here. 6 yards away from picking up the first here on 2nd down. Play fake. Rivers on the move to his left. Under pressure, and he'll go down back at the 26-yard line. DeAndre Levy able to run him down for a loss of a yard. They haven't made much of this great starting field position they had. First and 6. Rivers. And this is going to be incomplete. He was looking for Julian Edelman that time. And now it's 4th down.
Let's go ahead and try and get into the body and the mind of the linebackers. Yeah, I know they're bigger and stronger than I ever was. But in this situation, they understood what was going on as much as the offensive guys. Because the offensive guys always taught, find the first down sticks and make the play. On defense, what do you want to do? Guard the first down line. Make sure they don't get there and tackle them in front. They were able to drop in their zone coverage, figure out where the first down line was, and end up making the play, swatting it away so they couldn't get the completion.
And last year, that would have been a net gain of 5 on the return. This year, he stopped where he would have been if he had taken a knee, and that's at the 25. The Redskins offense now, they head back onto the field. And on that last drive, went for it on 4th, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held them to 3, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on 4th down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than 3. And that's exactly what happened.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game. But I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it's the defense getting it done again and holding them to no game.
And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Give them a lot of credit. They ended up running the ball on a key third down situation. They were staring three and out in the face and found a way to flip the script and keep the ball moving on offense.
And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. On the handoff, it's Gurley. And he is going to lose yardage here. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down. 12 yards to go on third down.
Brandon, that play ended so fast, it's almost as if the quarterback handed it to the runner and the tackler was there right away for a loss of yardage.
And it'll be a minimum pickup here as it will take us to the end of the first quarter. Back live, Charles Davis to my right. I'm Brandon Gaudin. It's Redskin football to begin quarter number two, but likely not for long as they're in punt formation to kick it away. Brady not coming to the sideline. They're going to go for it here on fourth. Eifert, the man in motion. Here we go on fourth down now with Brady. And it is incomplete. A surprising move to go for it. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And the Cardinals will now take over with excellent position. On first and 10, Rivers. And the Redskins do get to him. He goes down for a sack. Dayton Jones in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10. Now a second down throw for Rivers. And pressure coming, and they got him once again. Dayton Jones in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon. Third and long for Rivers. Middle of the field, he's got Nelson. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. J.J. Nelson, 55 yards. And the Cardinals will extend their lead. Pass, clean catch, and a house call there on the fly route.
And not that much room to operate. So that tells you about his acceleration. We always talk about being able to go from 0 to 60 real fast. It takes less time than that to get the top speed and complete that play.
And following the touchdown now is Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turnover 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. Gurley. And he's got room. And a cutback right sideline. And they finally do get him, but not before he reaches the 27. So Gurley gashes the defense. A lot of people say, do you take running backs early first round? You want them that high? Surely you're happy you took Todd Gurley that early.
Without a doubt, Dr. Seuss. I love the way that that got done by you. But even better, it's fun to watch Todd Gurley run the football. He is electrifying.
I want you to know that I did not mean to do that, by the way. Pernell McPhee in there on the stop.
Now that's the type of play that'll fire up the defense. Hold them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all, if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
He was trying to hit Taylor Gabriel that time, and now it's third down.
Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball, but for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try and knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab him. That'll be a holding penalty. So all you're trying to do is make some type of a play on him, make some type of contact to try and get his arms out of the sky.
Throwing is Brady on third down. finding Gabriel complete. The 21 yards there as they convert on third. Brief break in the action here. More from Minneapolis after this. First and goal from the five. On first and goal, Gurley. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Redskins. Todd Gurley, a five-yard touchdown run. And the Redskins will have a close game again. Cairo Santos on to try the extra point. And they're back with a field goal. It's 10-7 now. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. So it shifts past him. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. So out now come the Cardinals. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counter-punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled down. Good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
See if they dial it up this drive. Rivers to throw it. Eluding the pressure line. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got a first half. Jay Howard able to drop him for a loss of a couple. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Second down, Rivers. And a hit guarded loose. It's incomplete.
That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
On third down, Rivers. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the Michigan man, Jake Ryan. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And that last drive, it was all about the ground game, ground and pound.
And I don't care how we're playing the game these days, offensive linemen still want to fire out and smack the guy opposite them and move the football on the ground. They feel better about that.
That's Todd Gurley. Wave goodbye. Touchdown, Washington. Todd Gurley with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Redskins have taken the lead. And that makes it 14-10. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about...
Now a hit, and Rivers lost the football. And they'll have a short field to work with inside the 15 at the 13-yard line. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Gardner, I love your description because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking a big-time jaunt? Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play-action pass could very well be open.
Second down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. And the dreaded third and long here for the offense. Here's Gurley. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the five at the six. And the move from Mike McCarthy is going to be to keep the offense on the field here on fourth down. They're going for it. They're running with Gurley. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. Todd Gurley in the final seconds of the first half. And the Redskins are going to add on to their lead. And he knocks it through. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. And the Cardinals getting set to trot out there now. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So as they take it over, we step aside. Final play of the half, Rivers. And he whips that one incomplete there. So we have reached halftime here in an 11-point contest. As we'll send you down to Orlando, where Larry Ridley has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry, so both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. So here's the Cardinals offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a real,
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Over the middle, the connection to Hearns. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39.
One of the feature points of the end route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. The former seventh-round pick, Julian Edelman, just continues to have such a productive career.
And has made himself into a receiver. Remember, he was a college quarterback, and not just a productive one, a very good one.
At Kent State, right?
Yes, a great leader, a guy who could make plays with his feet and his arm. Got to the NFL and had to convert into being a receiver and was drafted that way. And that conversion, oh boy, it's been good.
Offense looking to avoid a third and long at second and 10. To the air again here, Rivers. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. Vance McDonald, the tight end, was the target. Third down here.
Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. That one will go down as 33 yards on the third down conversion. And now a first down following that long gain. From the red zone now, Rivers. Trying to squeeze it into Edelman, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And the return just out across the 15 to the 16-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. The one running back is Gurley. So after the INT, it's Brady. Dumps it off to Gurley. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. A solid gain of 15 yards in the sticks move.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
If he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
Now Brady throwing on second down. He'll throw underneath for Gurley. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. On first and 10, here's Brady. Complete to the right side, it's Eifert. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
So the offense looking at a second and 8. Brady to throw on second down. And they'll set up the screen to Gurley. Taken down at the 44-yard line. They get 9 out of that one. As a result, the drive continues. And the offense lining up first and 10. Another pistol look here. Throwing on first down is Brady. A dump off to Anderson. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. 13 yards there on the pickup. And that leads to a Washington first down. Back now at beautiful new U.S. Bank Stadium. It's the Redskins with the football and the lead as we start the fourth. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. The one running back is Gurley. On first down, Brady. And incomplete on the deep ball. His big tight end, Tyler Eifert, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down. Back to the workhorse today. It's Gurley. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. They get 6 here after the incompletion, and it'll leave them with a 3rd and 4. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try to lead it out.
Just a yard on the run there. That's going to bring us to a 4th down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this 3rd down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stopped them for almost no gain.
It's a gain of 5 on the play, and on 4th down, they're able to convert and move the sticks. From the pistol, it's Gurley. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. 5 yards, he's the tally on 1st down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
And that's exactly what you want on a 1st down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up 2nd and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Now he'll throw with Brady. Dumps it off to Gurley. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it leads to a 1st and goal.
And when you have a guy in the backfield who can catch the football, you don't just use him strictly for checkdowns or dump offs. You make him part of the primary passing attack, because what you're trying to do is get him into open field and then let him make people miss and advance the football.
And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. Tom Gurley from 4 yards out. And the Redskins find a way to stretch their lead. There are several elements to a well-executed screen pass. This one resulted in a touchdown. It had all of those elements.
Hey, you're so right, because you really need the rush to almost get to the quarterback, almost get to the passer. then you've got to get the ball thrown perfectly, whether it's to the running back, the wide receiver, whoever the screen guy is. And, of course, the blocking has to form in front to get him downfield for the touchdown.
And last year, that would have been a net gain of 5 on the return. This year, he stopped where he would have been if he had taken a knee, and that's at the 25. And the Cardinals offense here ready to take over. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. And McDonald here over the middle. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
They got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets them a new set of downs.
Okay, when the big guy runs a corner route, you're asking a lot no matter who's covering him. Doesn't matter whether it's a linebacker or a defensive back.
Yeah.
He usually has the advantage because of his body type.
They go play action here on first down. Over the middle, the connection to Hearns. And a nice gain of 21 yards. And he went in route there from the slot for the completion.
Love how he runs his routes because it's all setting up your defender. Give him a little something one way, take him the other way. Head and shoulder fake. Sometimes you make one step to the outside, then break it inside. Really well run route.
A first down throw here for Rivers. Steps away to his left. He finds Hearns, left side. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Everyone has their strengths, able to move to their right or their left, being able to throw the football. So that means you've got to work on both because you never know which way you're going to get flushed by pressure. In this situation, able to escape to his left and makes an accurate throw.
Oh, nearly picked. And maybe lucky there. This guy doesn't drop many defensively. Third down. They'll run it now out of the gun. Call it no gain that time, and they're going to be left looking up at a 4th and 1.
That was a terrific job by the defense stopping them on 3rd and short. But sometimes you get some visual cues from the offense because when they're going in short yard situations, you might see the offensive line come in tighter together, a little more shoulder to shoulder, trying to wedge a hole in the middle. They didn't get it done on that play.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. So out comes the field goal team now for the 2nd time here today. From the left hash, this from 34. And the kick here is good. So add 3 to the total. But they're still coming up well short. And that is how this one comes to an end. Well, as always, partner, an extreme pleasure to share a booth with you. I have to say, I am impressed at your discipline because you came here and you said you were not going to eat any of the media buffet. You made it to the end. You didn't consume a single calorie.
I appreciate that. What you missed is me going to the concession stand outside of your eyesight and getting it done that way. Look, I mean, they were serving the good stuff. I had to do it.
Oh, man, but you're svelte, in good shape. But cheated a little bit. We'll let it slide.
I appreciate that. Always a pleasure to work with you.